it's about the Soulja Boy shit. Okay. I went to Soulja Boy's house on October 24th. When I went to Soulja Boy's house on October 24th, 2018, niggas laughed at me. Like, Soulja Boy was hardly getting 100,000 views on YouTube. He was getting... And I fuck with Soulja Boy so heavy. This is what I'm telling y'all. Nobody was trying to interview him. But it was funny because when I went to Soulja Boy house, niggas was in my, and these are big time rappers, niggas was in my DM talking about, why are you fucking with that lane? He's a lane. Don't fuck with Soulja Boy. He's a coke addict. He be renting his house is rented. He's da 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 da. I came with my nigga Mike T. His name Be Cool Mikey on Instagram. He was with me. And I said, because when we went to Soulja Boy, Soulja Boy is such a cool dude. We played 2K and everything. And Soulja Boy was not on the blog sites. Nobody was fucking with Soulja Boy until I went to his mansion. I did the interview with Soulja Boy. Y'all laughed at him. Y'all said all his jewelry was fake. Y'all said, wow, why y'all fuck with Soulja Boy so heavy? Why y'all fuck with Soulja Boy so heavy? I looked over to my friend when we left his crib. I said, you know what? Soulja Boy's a real nigga. I'ma get him back popping. My friend looked at me and laughed like, nigga, you not gonna fucking get him back popping. You're not gonna do that. I said, Soulja Boy is a good dude. He let me and my homeboy come over, do an interview, smoke, play 2K, it was cool. So, I say that to say, so I look at my homeboy, we leave the crib, we leave Hidden Hills, Soulja Boy, real nigga. And this ain't the bad Soulja Boy, I'm just telling you how the industry is fake, because it's a lot of fake shit going on. So I'm at his crib, and I'm at Soulja Boy's crib, October 24th, right? And I told my friend, I was like, yo, I'm going to blow Soulja Boy up, I'm going to post him twice a day. I'm going to post him twice a day, right? He was like, it ain't gonna pick up. Soulja Boy shit ain't gonna pick up. This was around the time Soulja Boy was acting like he owned a Subway. I was just running with it. Like, every day we would post something. I told all my staff, I said, post him. Anything Soulja Boy does, post him. So, Soulja Boy's picking up steam. Academics ain't fucking with Soulja Boy at the time. No Jumper wasn't fucking with Soulja Boy. After I interviewed Soulja Boy, No Jumper interviewed him. But I say that to say, all the rappers were talking shit about Soulja Boy to me in my DMs, to us. Why you fuck with Soulja Boy? Why you posting him? Now he's hot. Go look at all the rappers under his page. It's a lot of rappers talking about Soulja Boy, you the GOAT. Soulja Boy, you this, you that. You a legend. These same niggas that I see under his post was talking down on Soulja Boy literally 2 months ago, man. I can't make this up. This industry's fake. And what's funny is that the Karen Civil stat that he just posted on his page, I made that stat up. I made the 78% stream rate shit. So she copied my shit. He didn't post the Say Cheese thing. He posted Karen Civil. It's just kind of weird. Like, a nigga that fucked with you from the beginning, you not showing love. I don't need Soulja Boy. I did it from the heart. I wanted to see Soulja Boy come up from the heart. And it was a genuine thing. And now everybody's riding his wave when they was just talking down on him. Talking about he was broke. All his jewelry was fake. And I was there fucking with him. So just watch out in this game how many fake rappers and how many people are out there, because they are wishing on your downfall. They are hating on you. They don't want to see you do better than them. It was so many people talking down on Soulja Boy when I went to his crib. When me and my team was posting him every day, Academics wasn't posting him. Shade Room, no other blogs were posting him but Say Cheese. And niggas was laughing at me and my team for always posting him. Now he's on top. Everybody's his friend. It's a fake industry, man. And I can't make it up, man. Like, you know. My point is that nobody was fucking with Soulja Boy 2 months ago. Everybody was hating on him. Now he's on top. Everybody's faking like they was fucking with him. You know what I'm saying? When we posted Soulja Boy 2 months ago, every day, niggas would, I'm gonna unfollow y'all if y'all post him again. Now y'all calling him the GOAT because he's on top and he's getting that attention. But when niggas are down and niggas need that love, where do y'all be at? That's my point. My point isn't that we put him on, because we definitely put him back on. But I'm not here for the pat on the back. I'm just here for the watch out. Who the niggas who smile in your face when you're up, when you're down, they not really fucking with you. And I don't need the clout at all. Like, niggas got 10 houses and niggas is good. Cars is paid for and all that. But, you know, I'm just letting y'all know, man, it's a fake game. It's a fake industry, man. And y'all already know what's going on. Laughing at Soulja Boy and shit. Niggas was asking us, you know. nah, facts. Niggas was hating on him like 2 months ago. And when we posted him every day, y'all was saying that he was paying us. Soulja Boy never paid me a dime. It was all out of love. I don't have 10 houses. Okay. Go on my personal page. Switch. Nah, facts. And it's like, damn, bro. Like, it's like when you speak real shit, you sound bitter, but it be the truth. Like, bro, that Karen Civil stat that you just posted was my stat that I made up. But instead of you sharing the blog that helped you, you share Karen Civil shit. But she copied my stat. Like, it's just funny shit that you see. You feel me? Like, all the blogs copied this shit. And I don't know. Whatever. What's good? Nah, he been to go. I fuck with Soulja. I'm speaking on how everybody's fake around, like all the industry people and niggas was just talking crazy about Soulja Boy in my DMs, for real. I don't give a fuck if you put this on YouTube. Yes, I had 10 houses. Go look at my personal page, Shawn Cotton. I do a lot of real estate shit. I'm in the fix and flip business for real. I'm not saying I put Soulja Boy on. I'm saying when nobody was fucking with him, Say Cheese was fucking with him. I'm not saying we put Soulja Boy on. I'm just saying that everybody that's in his face now, they weren't in his face 2 months ago. They was calling him a crackhead. I'm just saying keep the real niggas around you that was fucking with you when you had nothing.
NBA Youngboy interview for me. They hate me. Spot him, got him. He's over here right now.
Hey, watch out for everything. Don't sign no label deals. Own all your masters in publishing. Make sure everything in the paperwork is cool. Don't sign shit. Build leverage. Get millions and millions and millions of views and then sign. Have them throw you that bag. And make sure you eat off the front end and the back end. They taking everything. They extorting everybody. For real. They extorting everybody. Make sure you own everything when you sign. Or don't sign at all. Nigga, keep struggling. Because once you sign, then you become a worker. You working for somebody else. Don't sign. It's all a finesse. Don't sign. And if you do sign, make sure it's 50-50. If you sign with somebody, make sure it's a 50-50 partnership. If you broke down bad, and it's a nigga with a little bit of bread, or a nigga with a bag, and he can help you out, break it down the middle 50-50. Don't sign. It's all a finesse. 300, they finessed me out of Rod Wave. And Quasha found him. You think 300 reached out and was like, I'ma give y'all a little something because y'all put us on Rod Wave? No. Name was one blog that was posting Rod Wave before he blew up. I went to the office like a dumbass. Me. I was a dummy. I went to 300 and I was like, yo, what's this nigga named Rod Wave? Y'all should fuck with him. You think they threw me in the mix? No. They went and signed him and backdoored me. It's a fake game. And y'all are going to keep talking shit until y'all get finessed. Y'all be like, damn, that nigga cotton. It's all a finesse. Keep struggling. Don't sign with nobody who's going to sell you dreams. They're going to make you sign the paper, and then they're going to shelf you. Keep struggling. It's going to be a long grind, but it's going to be worth it in the end. Keep struggling until you come up on that hit record, until you come up on that fan base. Ain't nothing wrong with struggling and rapping at the same time. Just because y'all see Migos and all them niggas wearing that jewelry and all that shit, your time coming. You just got to stay down. But instead, what y'all do is y'all get 100,000 views and then y'all sign to the first label. No, nigga. No, don't sign, nigga. Ownership, nigga. That's why I respect Nipsey Hussle so much, nigga. Ownership, nigga. Ownership, Currency, that's why I respect them niggas. You know why? I seen an interview with Currency. He was like, man, I couldn't afford that Rolex. I wanted to get that Rolex, but I finally got it. He could have got the Rolex 2 years ago if he would have signed. Or 5 years ago if he would have signed. But he got it on his own time. And on his own shit. It's about ownership, man. Y'all be so in a hurry to stunt. And I understand it. Y'all want to stunt on that bitch so bad they curved you. Y'all want to stunt on that nigga so bad who been hating on you. It's going to take time. But when the time come, it's going to feel so much better. You know why? Because you did it your way. You did it your way. Go ahead and sign to the white folks. Then you going to be on there like Day Day. Trying to cuss the nigga out that signed you. Because he stole your money. No, nigga. Do that shit on your time. Facts, nigga. This is what these niggas ain't telling you. But y'all go and listen to the other nigga who lying to you and he's selling you big dreams. No, nigga, keep recording. Keep putting out music until you reach those billions and millions and millions and millions and millions and millions of views. And still don't sign. Fuck them. Start your own label and then demand 30 million. I need 30 million. I need 30 million for me and my niggas. And then put your nigga on. And then your nigga, if he real, he gonna put his nigga on. And then boom, you got Rockefeller right there. Put this shit on YouTube. Put this shit on YouTube. I bet y'all won't put this shit on YouTube. Y'all put all the other shit on YouTube when I'm fighting with niggas and all that. Put this shit on YouTube, the real shit, on how to be a boss, nigga. On how to be a boss in this rap game, nigga. Cut out the middleman. Fuck the middleman. They taxing. And they taking your writers and your publishing, man. Fuck them niggas. You got everything you need. You got a motherfucking laptop. Go to fucking the white bull down the street. Record your own shit and put it on YouTube. It's easy. Run up the numbers on your own. Don't be buying views because niggas is buying views. But run up the shit on your own. Run up the shit on the own to the white man and be like, fuck it. I got 10 million for you. Y'all niggas signed it for 30 grand. Show y'all the right way. I'm about to change the game. I done found a loophole. I done found a fucking loophole. finessed too many times in this rap shit, and I've been humble. I ain't said nothing. I could expose a lot of shit. These niggas out here who be talking all that cocky shit, they don't own their masters or their publishing. Them niggas are workers. Why you think Uzi ain't dropped his tape yet? Nigga, I know all this shit, nigga. I know all the behind the scenes shit. You and your niggas get together and run them numbers up, nigga. And run fucking numbers up, nigga. Don't sign shit unless it's a partnership deal where it's you and somebody else have a partnership. You still own everything. They get 50-50, nigga. It may be a 360 deal, but it's better than 80-20. It's easy. This is easy information. You niggas laughing over here, but I'm giving you the game. I'm giving you the game. Instead of signing for somebody for $1 million, take that 20 grand from the dope boy and split it 50-50. If they offer you $1 million, they're going to want that $1 million back. You're going to be in debt. You know how hard it is to make $1 million off rap shit? I'm telling you niggas, man, you niggas sitting up laughing. That's why a lot of you niggas fell in y'all classes in school, because y'all want to be the class clown. I'm trying to put you niggas on game about how to finesse the rap game. Nigga, look at Chance the Rapper. Look at Nipsey and all these niggas. They do it when the time is right. You niggas get 50,000 views on YouTube and be quick to sign. I just saw that. No, slow down. You doing too much. Why? I'm trying to put you niggas on game, man. Because I love you niggas, man. You know why I love you niggas? Because we're the smartest generation. We finessed everything. I done found a loophole in this rap shit. We cutting out the middleman. We not signing no more dumb record labels, man. We doing partnerships 50-50. 50-50. We not signing no more dumb shit. We not giving away no masters, no publishing, nigga. We own our shit, nigga. That's what we doing. And when you get on, like I said before, put your niggas on. And if your nigga a real nigga, he gonna put his nigga on. And if your nigga a real nigga, he gonna put his niggas on. And then you got Rockefeller. You got state property. You got Dipset. Then who can stop you when 50 niggas is eating? It's cool when one nigga eating, but when 50 niggas eating, who can stop you? Who can stop you?
Shipway. Fact.
feel me? That beef shit dead. This year is so much money to get, man. How could you beef when there's so much beautiful women and nice cars? How could you? How could you worry about another nigga when there's so much money to get? How could you? It's so much money to get out here. How could you? It's so much money to get out here and we worry about other niggas. How could you? It's so many Lamborghinis and jet skis and palm trees and Ferraris and Lamborghinis and we worried about the next man. How could you? Email me for Say Cheese merch, for the Say Cheese merch too.